Namaste student, this is Sanjay Nath. Today's session is on rocks, chapter 6, part 2, ICSE standard 9. In this session, we learn about different types of rock, primarily sedimentary and metamorphic rock. We will understand what are sedimentary rocks. The name itself suggests that the sedimentary rocks are mainly formed due to deposition of sediments. Sedimentary rocks may be made up of rock fragments, debris and broken fragments of weathered rock, or by chemical reactions. The classification of sediments is shown below. As you can see in this sediment chart, the size of those sediments or the particles has been shown over here. Boulder is 256 mm plus, a cobble is 64 to 256 mm, a pebble is 4 to 64 mm, and a granule is 2 to 4 mm in size. Sand particle is 1 by 16th of 2 mm, and silt is a very fine particle, 1 by 256th or 1 by 16th mm. And clay is very fine particle, is less than 1 by 256 mm in size. With the help of this diagram, we'll understand how the sedimentary rocks are formed and what are the processes steps are involved. The parent rocks are broken down by the agents of gradation, mainly static and dynamic agents. Like you've learned in the previous chapter, these are temperature, and the dynamic agents are wind, water and ice. Among all the agents, water is the primary agent that plays a very important role. It does break the rock, and as well as it transport the sediment from one place to another place. This weathered particle is eroded by the action of water or wind. When they get transported from the higher altitude to the lower areas or the low-lying areas, they deposit the sediments in layers, primarily beneath the water body like rivers or the coastal areas or beneath the ocean. In the course of time, the sediment deposition pile up layer by layer horizontally beneath the ocean, and due to burial, they start the process of formation of sedimentary rock. In this process, they mainly undergo compaction and cementation. The combined process of compaction and cementation is called lithification. Now we'll understand what are the processes led to the formation of sedimentary rock. Sedimentary rocks are always formed due to the deposition of sediment in layers called stratum or stratified layer. There are two processes, compaction and cementation. In compaction, the sediments or the particles subject to a lot of pressure, due to which they tend to occupy the least possible volume. In this, sedimentary rocks undergo a lot of pressure. In cementation, the fragments of rock are mainly bound together by the calcium carbonate. Here the acidic water is the primary agent in cementation process. H2O plus CO2 equals to carbonic acid. This carbonic acid takes the chemically weak minerals like mica, calcite and feldspar into the solution, and it occupies the space between the rock fragments, thereby cementing them together. In this manner, cementation process also gives birth to a sedimentary rock. Now we'll understand in detail what are the three ways by which the sedimentary rocks are formed. First, mechanically formed sedimentary rock. In this, large fragments of rock are visible. These are called clast. Made up of cemented sediments are classified by their grain size. It is mainly controlled by the dynamic agents like river, wind, ice and sea waves. With the help of this table, you'll understand how different type of mechanically formed sedimentary rocks are formed. First, conglomerate. In this picture, this is conglomerate. As you can see, the rock fragments are rounded and they've been bound together by the mineral called clay, silt or sand, followed by breccia. In breccia, something very unique, all the rock fragments are angular fragments. They've been bound together by clay or silt. Sandstone, fine or coarse grained sandstone. The primary mineral present in that is quartz. Siltstone, very fine grain. Siltstone is a very fine grained sedimentary rock. Followed by that, shale. Shale is a compacted, may be split easily, and this is mainly formed due to the bonding of clay. Now we'll understand by second way by which the sedimentary rocks are formed. Chemically formed sedimentary rock. In this, we will not see clast or rock fragments. They're mainly formed due to the chemical precipitation and evaporation. Mainly they settle down in the solution. Halite is rock salt and gypsum. As you can see in this table, there are some examples being shown over here. Rock salt is primarily formed due to the deposition of halite. There are no primary clast are visible in that. They are mainly formed due to the precipitation of halite. Second one is rock gypsum. This is mainly formed due to the chemical precipitation or evaporates. Dolostone is also one crystalline chemically formed sedimentary rock. Followed by that, limestone and coal we'll see in the next slide. They are mainly formed due to the dead remains of plants and animals. Now we'll learn about biologically formed sedimentary rock. Mainly they come from the remains of organic matter. In this, the best examples are the different types of coal: anthracite, bituminous, lignite and peat. Anthracite coal results from the greatest pressure and releases the most energy when burned. They're mainly of high calorific value. Other variations are bituminous, lignite. These are called petrified permineralized wood and another organic rocks. Petroleum and other fossil fuels are mainly formed due to the fossilification of marine organisms. Organically formed sedimentary rocks are also called the biologically formed sedimentary rocks. They're mainly formed at the freshwater conditions on the continents. Now we'll learn how metamorphic rocks are formed. Metamorphic rocks are formed by the heat and pressure, changing the existing rocks into a new rock. As a result, when a new rock subject to a lot of heat and pressure, it will convert to a new metamorphic rock. The process is called metamorphism. Rocks lose their original physical structure. For example, such as layers in the case of sedimentary rock get disappeared, and the chemical composition also get altered, and the new minerals will form. Now we'll see some examples of metamorphic rocks. Basalt will convert into schist, granite will convert into gneiss, shale will convert into slate, and slate will convert into schist. Sandstone to convert into quartzite, limestone, that is calcium carbonate CaCO3, will convert into marble, coal to graphite, and when the graphite gets further metamorphosed will give birth to the allotrope of carbon called diamond. Now we'll see what are the ways by which the metamorphic rocks are formed. First, regional metamorphism. The name itself suggests that such metamorphism occurs at large scale. It mainly at the plate boundaries where the two plates meet. With a tremendous amount of pressure and heat, where the temperature range from 900 degrees Celsius plus. As you can see in this diagram or the sketch, the two plates are converging at one point, and in large scale when the two plates converge, the plates rub against each other. That result into tremendous amount of heat and pressure, and the resultant rock convert into a new rock called metamorphic rock. Such type of metamorphic rocks are formed at large scale at the plate boundaries or near the mountain belts. The second way by which the metamorphic rocks are formed is called contact metamorphism. The name itself suggests that here the metamorphic rocks are formed due to contact. It mainly affects the rock on a local scale, such as baking of sedimentary rocks, or you can say the surrounding or adjacent rocks, or due to hot magma. The heat reaches up to 300 to 800 degrees Celsius. As you can see in this sketch, a magma chamber, and there are vents and capillaries are there, through which the magma spurts out toward the surface. The hot magma, when it come in contact with this adjacent rock, due to contact heating, the rocks get altered and they convert into a new metamorphic rock. For example, if this layer is made up of limestone, the heat may convert the rock up to such an extent into marble. Such type of metamorphism is called contact metamorphism. Now, what are the locations where contact metamorphism or regional metamorphism are common? Is near igneous intrusion. This is called the igneous intrusion, near the mountain belts and deep inside the earth crust. With the help of this table, we'll understand the scheme for metamorphic rock. Here, we can see the two textures of metamorphic rock, foliated and non-foliated. Foliated means that the metamorphic rock will break in linear pattern. Now, we'll see some examples of metamorphic rock. Slate. Slate will form due to metamorphism shale. When the slate gets further metamorphosed, it will convert into phyllite. The primary mineral present in the phyllite is mica crystals. Followed by that, when the phyllite gets metamorphosed, it will convert into schist. The primary mineral present in schist is clay and feldspar. When the schist gets further metamorphosed, it will convert into gneiss. These are the best examples of metamorphic rocks where physical and chemical properties has completely altered. Now we'll see some examples of non-foliated metamorphic rock, where you cannot see any linear pattern, like sandstone will convert into quartzite and limestone will convert into marble. Now we'll understand what are the characteristic features of metamorphic rocks. Structure. For example, a sedimentary rock may initially have layers, and these layers get disappeared due to intense heat and pressure and metamorphosed to a new rock. There will be no longer any layer seen or visible, and they may have a granulitic texture. Apart from that, the minerals, the original rock may be sedimentary or contain minerals such as calcite or quartz. The resultant metamorphic rock may consist of corderite, cerebenite and spanel. There is a very interesting example of metamorphic rock that not get completely converted to metamorphic rock. In this, the mineral composition of the rock does not change, but only the original structure has altered and not obliterated. The rocks is said to have undergone a process of diagenesis. The best example of diagenesis, that is granite converted into gneiss. Now, what are the sources of heat and pressure involved in the formation of metamorphic rock are listed below. heat, and pressure. Primarily the magma, uprising magma. That magma caused the surrounding rocks to get altered into a new rock. Due to friction between the two plates or lithospheric plate against each other, also responsible for the formation of metamorphic rock. Pressure, the overlying sediments. The weight of the overlying sediments also create tremendous amount of heat that alters the rock into new rock called metamorphic rock. Even the rising magma during igneous intrusion also responsible for the formation of metamorphic rock. At the large scale metamorphism, collision of two lithospheric plates at convergent boundaries is also responsible for the formation of metamorphic rock, where tremendous amount of pressure is responsible for formation of such rocks. The temperature on an average is near 300 to 800 degrees. Some of the examples of metamorphic rock: schist, gneiss, and marble. Thank you for watching the presentation.